If you guys would like to pick up any of the figures you see in today's video, go over to ringsidecollectibles.com and use the promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10%. What is good, everybody? Welcome to an epic My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we finally have them, ladies and gentlemen. Elite Series 76 finally in the house. Came back from vacation. Of course, they arrived literally like hours after I left for vacation. I couldn't wait. You know, we were trying to get down there as early as possible. They arrived at the door, and now it is finally time to review these suckers. I didn't post yesterday. Upset my feelings very much. But we're back here today with three reviews, guys. After this one, if you're watching this when it first goes live, the rest of the review should be up in the next 30 minutes or so. And if you're watching this later in the day, definitely go check out the rest of the set after you watch this video. And then, of course, the final video will be the set fully ranked for you guys. I know others try to do that now, too. But anyways, guys, we have heavy machinery in the house. Otis and Tucker. I feel like Tucker kind of fell off there with all the hype to Otis. You know, he kind of just broke off on his own thing. Mr. Money in the Bank in the house. We are going to take a look at what he looks like with that money in the bank. Will these figures be unique to themselves? You know, they got their own unique body molds going on and stuff like that. How will they compare? How is their articulation? What are the details? Let's get the hell into it, guys. Starting off with your front viewing window, you got all the stuff. Both guys, first time in the line, never got a battle pack or anything of these guys. Spinning it to the right, you have a beautiful image of Otis and Tucker. I think Otis has got the more handsome mug, guys. What do you guys think? Let me know down in the comment section below. Spinning it to the right, we have the same exact photograph of both guys. Feels kind of, I feel like it used to be an action shot like that, but what the hell do I know? They have the exact same bio read. You got the exact same finisher. Opposite bull crap here. Rest of the figures in the wave. Another image shot of them here, and then that is pretty much it, guys. So with that being said, let's go ahead and crack heavy machinery out of their packaging. And you know what's kind of weird? I just realized that I got some heavy machinery back here. This little crane wrecking ball thing. Who cares? Alright, guys, so here is Otis and Tucker out of their packaging, looking pretty swell. You know, I took them out, I posed them around a little bit, got the feel of each figure, and so far, so good, Brad, but we're gonna dive in deeper to it. You guys already know how we do, but with these guys, they come with the exact same zigzag. What the fuck am I even saying?
What the hell is even that? What the hell?
Daddy, chill.
They come with the exact same accessories, right? So, let's go ahead and just review both of their accessories together, and then we will take a closer look at these guys also together, maybe one after another, and then we will just kind of do them together. Since they're a tag team, since they do business together, you know, we're gonna keep them together. They have the exact same thing, so let's go ahead and dive into their accessories, and then we'll dive into Otis and Tucker themselves. So getting into Heavy Machinery's accessories, guys, they come with the exact same thing, but they do have their own signature vest. You do have Tucker's vest right there where it says solid. You gotta zoom in here. You got some nice patches. You got blue collar. You got solid Tucker. You got all these tears in there, which actually are, not only are they painted on there, but they're actually sculpted. Like, it's got some feels to it. It's got little rough edges. Got the Heavy Machinery logo on here. Very cool. All of this is actually detailed, and it is molded on there, so it's not, you know, just whatever. It's not just painted on it. It's actually sculpted in there with the rubber and all the details right there, which is very cool to see. I love that. Same thing with Otis, which is pretty much the same thing. It says solid blue collar. Says Otis. I think they are the exact same mold, except one of them obviously says Otis and the other says Tucker, if you guys wanted to know. And they do have their Heavy Machinery logo, but I do believe they're the exact same mold. And if you guys wanted to see what these guys look like in these things, I will go ahead and do that for you now. So there is Otis in his coat, and I'm not really liking the way it fits the figure. I feel like it just doesn't fit a little bit right, but there you go nonetheless. And here's Tucker in his coat, and I think it fits Tucker a little bit better. It's probably because Otis is a little bit wider of an individual, but there you go in both of their entrance jackets. And then as far as their other accessories, guys, go, you've got the Yolo County Tag Team Champions. Now, I don't remember this on Raw. I do not remember anything about this.
I don't know what that is. I've never seen that.
I really can't remember it at all. It's not ringing a bell to me, but there you go. You get these cardboard championships, and they are actually made of like a box material, which is pretty cool. They're very realistic, if you want to say. You know, they don't mold or anything like that. They are, I mean, you could bend it if you wanted to. It will go back, but it feels like a piece of cardboard or construction paper-esque, very paper-like, which is very realistic if it's a cardboard championship. And then out of the packaging, they do come with mic holding hands, and then they do come with interchangeable fists and interchangeable throne sitting hands, or, you know, prayer hands, or whatever you want to call these. Claymore kick hands where you slap the thigh. I don't know. There's a lot of names for these hands. Push-up hands. You guys get the point. But that does it for their accessories, guys. So that being said, let's dive into Otis and Tucker themselves. So starting off with Tucker from Heavy Machinery, guys, getting into all his good stuff. Now, as far as his face scan, I'm not exactly sure if it looks like him. I don't know what it is about looking at Tucker, but I don't really see him fully in this head sculpt. It may just be the specific image that I'm looking at, but I feel like the eye shape may be a little bit off. But nonetheless, as you spin him around, you will see he does have this nice slick back. It's kind of crazy. It's like one straight flat piece. It reminds me like of Jax back in the day. They used to have a hair piece like this. You'll see this little nick on the shoulder. This was in blue, but then I like scraped off the blue and it scratched off all the paint, so now it's like this black colorway right there, so it kind of looks like a little birthmark or a tattoo or something. But spinning it around, we have seen this body mold before. I'm sure, I could be wrong, this may be a completely new torso mold. If it is, I cannot remember if it is a older one or not, so somebody let me know. All of his tattoos look great though. I love all the tattoo deco that we've gotten here. I think all the tattoos are super clean. I like the colors we got going on. Here's as far as his ab will crunch forward, if you guys were wondering about that. Back and forth right there. You got the Heavy Machinery logos. He's got the Luke Harper / Eric Rowan style arms. No wrist tape or anything like that. He is on ball joints. He's got the big thighs going on. Open knee pads with the logos. You got the TK for Tucker Knight right there on his boots. Articulation is pretty solid. I love the bend of the knee there, and he does have ball joints, so he should be able to do any poses that you guys need him to do. But that's pretty much Tucker, man. I mean, I don't know what else to say. You guys can let me know what you think of Tucker down in the comment section below, but let's compare him to his boy Otis and see who the more superior figure is bringing Otis into frame, guys. Let's find out about Otis's business right here and take a zoom in shot of this head sculpt. And I think this Otis head sculpt is freaking fantastic. Now, I will say I wish the beard was a little bit thicker. I think the thicker beard would look even better, but I do like this head sculpt. He's got that weird Otis thing going on about him. I like the hair color. You know, it's a bit orange, but I think it works for Otis. I think it fits everything going on. You have that King Mabel like ab rotation, like pivot going on with it. Think that looks really good. They did give him the Brock Lesnar style arms, like Braun Strowman and Brock Lesnar. Now, I don't know how I feel about that. I feel like these arms would have probably worked better here for Otis, but maybe, I don't know, we'll just have to see about that. Maybe we can switch that out, or maybe there's a better option out there for him. I think the singlet looks good and everything. You guys are wondering right there, he can pull his hand up to his face right there if he wanted to talk on the microphone. You do have his long wet hair right there. Otis on the back. Now mine was having difficult, like I can spin it here, but I can't spin the waist. Now I think I need to just like pop it loose right here, because you guys can see right here my figure will not articulate at the waist. Now I don't know what that is exactly. There it goes finally, and it is a really tight waist. Like it feels really good in the hand. Going down, he is on ball joints again, and this is really, really unique. He's got the really massive thighs going on, but this is genius right here by Mattel. This is just grade one, just excellent stuff. Instead of giving him knee pads that would hinder articulation, guys, they actually sculpted the knee pads on. And so when you bend the knees, you do not have to worry about any hindered articulation. You guys can see there, the straps are molded on there. You don't have to worry again about any articulation issues. The heel almost touches the butt cheek. That's how good his knee joints are. These boots are one of a kind. We've never seen these before with these Otis style boots, how they go up in the back. I feel like that may be a bit higher than they're supposed to go, but these are brand new boot molds. I love the colors going on with it. It's got great ankle pivot. They rotate really well. And just overall, just what an excellent freaking figure, bro. This is one of those figures that just feels excellent in the hand to pose around with. Like, I just want to kick someone's ass with this figure. Kind of reminds me of the Ronda Rousey, like probably not as poseable as Rousey because she's an Ultimate Edition, but you can do a lot of stuff with this. I think this is really cool. I am having a ton of fun kind of just posing around. He kind of reminds me a lot of King Mabel. If you guys ever owned that King Mabel figure from last year, Elite Series 68. But overall, I am impressed with both Tucker and Otis. I think these are really strong Mattel WWE Elite figures, and we'll see how they come in at our ranking when we get to that video after these next reviews. And as far as Elite figure comparisons, guys, we really don't have any Elite figure comparisons because we've never had any before. I don't have customs of them, and since they're a tag team, I would compare them to each other. But since we have that, let's go ahead and just compare them to Mandy Rose, since you guys know what I'm talking about. So there is Otis up next to Mandy Rose. If you guys are wondering, there's your little height difference right there. And overall, man, just really good figures. I think these figures are just getting better and better from Mattel. But that pretty much does it for your Elite figure comparisons of Otis and Tucker from Heavy Machinery. But that pretty much does it for our 2-in-1 Elite 76 Heavy Machinery review. Guys, if you guys would like to pick up any of the figures you see in today's video, go over to Ringside Collectibles WrestlingFigures.com. Use the promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10%. Now, you guys want to know, are these figures worth it? I would say absolutely. Now, I would say that Otis Otis is the better figure. I feel like Otis is probably more valuable. You know, he is Mr. Money in the Bank right now, so if you want to add that, if you want to add these guys to your tag team divisions of your pick feds, of your wrestling figure leagues, or whatever the hell you're doing, you definitely want to pick these guys up because they're a great tag team to add to your collection. You want to, you know, a more current main roster, you want to add these guys to it. But just if you love action figures, I would just say get Otis, man. That figure right there is phenomenal. It's very fun to pose around with, and I'm very, very impressed with it. But how will these guys stack up in our ranking of Elite Series 76, guys? Find out in the last video of our 2-in-1 series review. After this, go check out John Cena and Braun Strowman. They should be posted by the time you're seeing this. So definitely check out the rest of the figures in the wave of their reviews and check out the ranking of Elite Series 76 from worst to best in the Christian and Lacey Evans review. But I'm getting the hell out of here, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel, go to Ringside Collectibles, and use promo code MDTOYS to save money. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.